hear that call come over the radio, no matter what.
Today, the Iowa DCI will continue to investigate the deadly shooting of a deputy near Sigourney. Thank you for joining us today. We will go live to Carrie Gavin in Sigourney in just a moment. But first, here's some background on the tragic murder of a Keokuk County deputy. This all unfolded yesterday about noon near Sigourney, about a half hour east of Oskaloosa in Keokuk County. Killed in the shooting, 38-year-old Keokuk County Sheriff's Deputy Eric Stein. The suspect also was shot and killed. He has been identified as 53-year-old Jeff Creer. Carrie Gavin arrived in Sigourney earlier this morning, and she now joins us live with the very latest on the situation. Carrie?
Good afternoon, Molly. Authorities are not releasing much more information, but here's what we do know. I can tell you that DCI Director John Quinn pulled up here about 11:30 this afternoon. Just about 5 minutes ago, a sheriff's deputy with Keokuk County came out and told us that the DCI will not be holding a press conference today. They will not be releasing any more information as of right then. It might be possible that we will get some information from the Keokuk County Sheriff, but not from DCI. But this is what we do know about what happened yesterday. Deputy Eric Stein was called to this farmhouse along with two other members of the Keokuk County Sheriff's Office. When they arrived just before noon, they were greeted with gunfire. They were there to talk with Jeff Creer about an incident that allegedly happened Sunday night. Authorities say that's when Creer opened fire from inside the home. Deputy Stein was struck at least one time. He died at the scene. Now, shortly before 3 o'clock yesterday, the alleged gunman came out of the home with weapons, and that's when he was shot and killed by officers. Now, court records show that Creer has somewhat of a criminal history dating back 15 years when he was charged with stalking and carrying illegal weapons. In 1997, he was acquitted of those charges by reason of insanity after going to a psychiatric evaluation at the state mental hospital. In 2000, he was also charged with assaulting a police officer. He spent 3 months in jail for that charge. Now, we're also learning more about Deputy Eric Stein, 38 years old. He was a deputy on the force here for 10 years. Prior to that, he also was a public servant as a paramedic. Stein, who his family tells us was from Watchier, where he was also a member of the volunteer fire department. His family says he has a 9-year-old daughter named Shelby. They describe him as outgoing but quiet, a man who enjoyed sports, especially baseball. Now we're live here at the Keokuk County Sheriff's Office. I want to show you the flag that's being hung at raised at half staff. Of course, that is for Deputy Stein. The sheriff's deputy that I was telling you about earlier came out about 5 minutes ago. He told us that funeral arrangements are being made by Stein's father, so there is no details on funeral arrangements just yet. He also told us that the sheriff here will be willing to speak with the media later today, but it is unknown at what time and exactly what he will say, but the DCI will not be releasing any more information today. We will continue to follow this story and bring you the latest on News Channel 8 at 5 and 6, and of course on KCCI.com. Molly?
All right, Carrie, thank you very much for that update. We appreciate it.